Welcome to Wait Till You Hear This. I'm Steve Eastman. The website for Duke Energy excitedly says, a smart meter is a great way to give you more control over how you use your energy. You can even log into your Duke Energy account to see your daily energy usage between billing cycles. Sounds customer-centric, doesn't it? I suspect it's the same kind of customer concentricity that a spider feels toward an insect that is about to be caught in its web. Here's something you might not know about smart meters. There's a British company called Onzo that sells software that helps utility customers analyze their customers' smart meter data. Onzo put out a promotional video which said,
we are Onzo. We help energy utilities globally to build better relationships with their customers, serve them more efficiently, and sell them in a more effective way. How do we do this? We take energy consumption data from smart meters and sensors. We analyze it using our patented algorithms and build a highly personalized profile for each and every utility customer. We then tag this profile with the key behavioral, attitudinal, and lifestyle characteristics that we identify. We even tag the appliances that we see being used in the home. We then use this characterized profile to give the utility three things. 1. Customer engagement apps that educate the end customer, build levels of trust, and ultimately reduce customer churn. 2. A detailed description of each end customer that helps the utility to provide more appropriate services and highly targeted sales campaigns. 3. The ability to monetize their customer data by providing a direct link to appropriate third-party organizations based on the customer's identified character. So, from a very thin stream of energy consumption data, Onzo delivers significant business value for as little as the price of a cup of coffee.
That promotional video has since been taken down because it was getting too much attention from people outside the industry. Let me ask you something. To put it in the words of the Onzo video, do you really want to give your utility the ability to monetize your data by providing a direct link to third-party organizations based on your identified character? To put it another way, your electric company would be selling information about when and how you use various electrical devices in your home, and that information would be available in real time. Now, shifting from my state to California, Timothy Allen Simon of the Public Utilities Commission has called third-party access reasonable. He also said it could stimulate market interest. Indeed. There's another issue to consider. Duke Energy admits on its website that smart meters produce radio frequency emissions. They're supposedly lower than those of cell phones. But organizations that do not have a financial interest in selling your data have reported results of 100 to 1,000 times the radiation level of mobile phones. Let's see, who should we believe? Since I am a customer of Duke Power, affected by this upgrade, I called in to ask some questions. The entire conversation lasted about 15 minutes, with plenty of break time while I listened to elevator music. I've condensed it here so you can get the main points. Notice I may seem to be belaboring the issue about the conversation being recorded. I did that because in my state, it's not legally necessary to get someone's permission to record them. You just have to make sure they know they're being recorded.
Good evening. Thank you for calling Duke Energy. To ensure you receive accurate and courteous service, this call may be recorded.
Good afternoon, this is Carmen.
Yes, I'm calling about the smart meter program. I think it just said there at the beginning of the thing that we're being recorded, are we?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. We're recorded then. That's okay. I'm not interested in having a smart meter. What are my options?
Carmen was not able to help me, so she transferred me to Jay.
Good evening. This is Jay.
Yeah, I've got a question about the smart meters. They said before that our conversation's being recorded, and that's okay with me. I'm not interested in having a smart meter. What are my options?
To answer your inquiry in regards to the smart meter, Unfortunately, there is no choice in terms of not having the smart meter. Duke Energy is moving away from the traditional meters so that there is more, it prevents a technician from having to come into the neighborhood to read the meter.
My wife talked to someone earlier and said that it would be a one-time fee of $150 and $11.75 a month to keep the meter that I've got. Is that correct?
That you would be charged to keep the meter that you have?
Right. Rather than change it, they said I could opt out if I paid $150 one time and $11.75 a month. Was it the information she was given incorrect?
Yeah, I would have to follow up with my supervisor to inquire because you wouldn't be charged anything. This is something that Duke Energy is moving toward.
No. I mean mm-hmm. They had told her that we would be charged if we opted to keep our current meter.
Correct.
$150 one time and $11.75 a month. We could keep the current meter and not have the smart meter. Did you get some bad info there?
I believe that that's incorrect, but I just want to follow up with my supervisor to make sure, because we wouldn't, across the board, Mr. Eastman, we're installing smart meters for our customers so that it will prevent technicians to have to come out to the location and possibly have human error in writing down the meter readings from the current meter that you have. That's why smart meters our customers are being transferred over to that. And it gives the customer greater control, faster service, a quicker response time to power outages, and fewer estimations on bills. So that's part of the reason why we are moving towards smart meter. As far as opting to keep and having to pay $150 as a one-time fee, that I'm not aware of. I have not received any information on that. When she did she call in and ask for that, inquire about that, or did
right.
we call her?
I called in.
Yes.
And let me. Yeah, I would appreciate if you could call me back on that when you have some more information. And also, do you use a company called Onzo to analyze the information and to sell it to third parties for advertising purposes?
No, you're saying Onzo to analyze your meter readings?
Yeah, Onzo is a British company that puts out software that helps utility customers analyze their customers' smart meter data. And basically it's used so that the information can be linked in real time to third-party advertisers or other people. Does Duke do something like that?
No, we wouldn't do anything like that without advising you that you have the option to use a different product or so forth. But if you hold for me just 1 to 2 minutes, Mr. Eastman,
okay.
I can certainly get to the bottom of the fact of the $150 fee.
Okay.
That does not sound right to me, but there may have been some information that came out earlier today that I am not aware of. And I work third shift, so I haven't been able to go through all my emails. So let me just check into that for you. You don't mind holding for a minute or two?
It turns out Jay could not provide me with a final answer about opt-out fees. Someone was supposed to call back, but as of the time I'm recording this program, no one has. I don't trust what Jay was telling me about whether Duke sells customer information to third-party advertisers. I don't think she was lying, but I doubt the company would tell its third-shift customer service people all the intimate details about a deal like this. You know, plausible deniability. As far as opting out, either way is not very customer friendly to me. Either I can't opt out, or I have to pay a lot more for the same level of service. This is Steve Eastman for Wait Till You Hear This.
Discover more stories like this one on our website, waittillyouhearthis.com. We'll be right back.